take a moment to ground yourself, to just feel the floor beneath you, relax your knees, re-relax your hips and your ankle joints, and take a moment to just breathe in and start a roll down. Tuck the chin into your chest, gently tuck those lower ribs in, pulling in the lower tummy as you curl it down, vertebra by vertebra, letting the head and the arms just dangle, breathing into the back, breathing down into your bottom. And as you breathe out, push the floor away as you roll it up and just try to anchor into the center of your heels, lifting the pelvic floor, pulling the belly button in and out, and coming to stand head on top of your tail. Just taking a nice deep breath in, raise the shoulders up, slide the shoulders down, and then just pick up all 10 toes and just feel the big ball, the baby ball, the heel into the floor. And then lower those toes down, gently lifting the arches of the feet, sensing the inner thighs, and rolling it down again, vertebra by vertebra. Breathing down into the back as you pull the tummy up away from your thighs. Relaxing the neck, relaxing the knees. Taking a nice big breath down into the bottom, letting the pelvic floor be nice and elastic, and rolling it up again. Engaging the front of the pelvic floor like you need a wee or like you want to stop mid-flow. Pulling the belly button in and up, coming to stand tall, pubic bone into neutral, bringing it forward, breathing in, take the shoulders up. Breathing out, slide the shoulders down, breathing in, lift the toes up, feel the balance in the tripods of the feet, lower the toes back down, and roll it down. One more time, curling chin to chest, letting those arms just dangle, then the head just hang. Breathing down the back because the tummy is gently compressed. We're going to stretch those legs as much as you can in this moment, staying in the middle of your feet, and then bend your knees again. And stretching the legs and bending the knees, pulling in the tummy away from the thighs, stretching the legs. And now just bring that body weight forward over the toes slightly. Feel how that subtly changes the stretch. Rocking gently back into the heels and feeling that subtle change. And then coming into the middle of those feet, balancing between the front and the back of the foot. We'll bend those knees, try stay in the middle of your feet, tuck your bottom under. Breathe out as you pull up the front of the pelvic floor, the lower belly, engaging those deep transverse muscles in those lower tummy areas. And coming up to stand tall, shoulder blades coming up. And shoulder blades coming down. And lifting all 10 toes, just finding that balance again. And then lowering them back down to the ground. We're going to go up to the arms. Just take those arms up sideways, lifting. Let the base of the ribs widen. Reach it over to the right side, relaxing in the neck and the shoulder. Just feeling the stretch through the side of the body. Push down into the left foot and come back up nice and tall. And going over to the other side, breathing in. Let it stretch through the right side of your body, push down into that right foot and press back up nice and tall. Over again, over to the side, watch the tension in the neck and the shoulders. And try to keep that pubic bone forward and pressing into the feet and coming back up tall. One more to the other side. Breathing in, feeling yourself grow longer rather than just contracting into the side and then bringing it back up. Rubbing your hands together for me. Just feeling your touch and gently placing those hands over your eyes. Just letting your head rest into your hands for a moment. Let the tension come away from your neck and shoulders. And breathe. We're going to tap ourselves on the head. Just driving that negative electrical charge. Tapping the spines of the shoulder blades. The bones holding the piezoelectrical charge that allows our nervous system to settle. Swiping across the back of those hips, across the sacrum. And one more time, rubbing the hands together. And as we rest the hands in the face, face into the hands. Just take a moment to invite yourself into a slower place, a calmer place, a more focused, clearer place. Coming to tap on the shoulder blades, on the sacrum, swiping across the lower back. This time we're going to canal bounces as well. If you can keep your eyes closed, just banging the heels on the ground and just kind of relaxing into it. Let your knees, your shoulders, everything just kind of jiggle as you're moving up and down, breathing. And stop bouncing, taking those arms up, lifting up nice and tall, going into a squat, send those hips back, long spine, tummy in, extend those fingers forward, inhale, open the arms out to the side, exhale, take the arms forward next to your ears, softening the ribs and pulling that lower belly in, and then dropping the arms down, folding over your bent legs, and push the floor away as you roll it back up again. This pattern another two times. Inhale, lifting those arms up. Feel the change in atmosphere in your shoulders as you let the shoulder blades move. And then soften the front of your hips as you let your buttocks widen, sitting back. Inhale, open those arms out to the side. Breathe out, soften the ribs, squeeze like you need a wee. Feel that gentle tone change in the lower tummy. Drop the upper body down over the legs, still pulling the tummy away from your thighs and rolling it up, letting that exhale and deeper scoop into those lower abs be what pushes you up through the spine. Letting the shoulder blades move, letting the chest stay soft and the neck stay long, and exhale into that seated position. Sending the buttocks back. Inhale, opening it out to the side. Exhale, take the arms forward, softening those ribs. Keep extending the sit bones back, dropping the chest down. Inhale into your back, right down into your bottom. Breathe out, pulling the tummy up away from those thighs, rolling it back up, vertebra by vertebra. We're going to check in with the feet again. Pubis into neutral, so the pubic bone is forward. Lift all those toes. Still balancing nicely, and take the toes back down to the ground. We're going to just find a balance on one foot. So I'm going to lift my right one. And just see if you can stand nice and still. He doesn't have to be super high. He doesn't have to be anything in particular. And breathe. Eyes on something that's not moving. Relax those shoulders and just breathe in for six counts. And out for six counts. And very gently feel the weight transfer as you put the right one down, or whichever one it was you were standing on, and then peel the other one off the floor. Notice your arch. You want to feel there's a subtle lift through the arch, engaging up into the inner thigh. My concentration when I'm balancing is often here in my belly button area, just to keep that from falling out, really, and then being top heavy and that pulling me over. And eyes on something that's not moving, and just breathing in for six counts. And out for six counts. I'm putting that foot back gently on the floor. Feel the weight transfer, breathing in. Breathe out as we roll it back down, folding down towards the floor. Softening into the knees and peeling it all the way down to the ground. We're walking the hands forward onto your all fours. And we're going to go straight into threading the needle, point those toes, and we're going to reach one hand behind the wrist. Folding and then push back up. And then the other hand, hand the wrist, ear and shoulder down to the ground and push back up. And again, we're going to do this three times each way. And then stop breathing. Think about the base of the ribs always needing to widen as you fill the lungs with air, and as that diaphragm contracts and releases. and coming back. Going to tuck under those toes and try to get the pinky toes tucked under as much as your big toes. Keep that back nice and flat and start rocking. And my intention here is to try and switch off those hip flexors a little bit as I rock back, allowing the butt to widen. But then some of us, our shoulders and our ribs tend to be intrinsically connected. So our ribs fall out, and as soon as we bring the ribs back up, the shoulders scrunch up. And when we put the shoulders down, the ribs fall out. So it has to be a balance of between the two. Find where you can keep those shoulders wide, pressing out with the hands to engage the lats, and that your ribs still feel like they are hugging your breastbone, hugging your chest. All right, let's come back into the middle. We take a nice big breath. The hands are spread out. And as you breathe out, pressing out with the hands, pressing down onto the toes, float the knees just off the ground. Feel those tummy muscles holding you up there. And breathe. And gently lower the knees back down onto the floor. Inhale. Exhale, pressing out with those hands. Feel the shoulder blades widening, pressing down onto the balls of the feet. Nice stretch under the metatarsals of the toes. And we're breathing. And everybody looks awesome. And lower those knees back down to the ground. One more time. Exhale as we press out with those hands, floating the knees just off the ground, buttocks out. And let's do a little rocking back and forward and back and forward, keeping those knees just hovering and the back as flat as you can. Watch the ribs falling. And then lowering those knees back onto the ground. Lovely. Pointing the toes. We're just going to do a little bit of a crawling. Opposite hand and knee, landing as gently as you can, crawling forward. When you get to the front of your mat, you start going backwards. Opposite hand and knee, and keeping the back extremely still. If you had a tray of gym glasses filled on your back, you are not going to drop or spill any gym. And walking forward when you get to the back of the mat again. Just keeping everything super still, like you are stalking your prey. Everything is nice and still. When we start going back this time, we are going to extend and then step back. And extend and step back. And extend, trying to land the hand and the knee at the same time, getting that synchronicity, timing. And think about stretching the back of the knee. Coming forward once you've reached the back of the mat again. Watch the tension in the neck and the shoulders. Tummy still lifted. Lovely gait patterning. And one more time, I think-ish. Coming back to the middle of your mat. And when you get there, let's just tuck those toes under. And let's just walk the feet in, just for a little fun. Knees to the outside of those arms. And let's just do a little bunny hop, just going up onto those hands and picking the feet up. And then try to slow it down. Slow it down. Try and get a little bit of balance and control. At the moment, we can't control much of anything except ourselves. So take control of yourself. I will not be fearful. I will stand on my hands. One more time. And up. And down. And then putting those hands down, stretching up into your up stretch. Shoulders nice and wide. Oh, butt sticking out. Heels down. We rise the heels up. Let that stick out your bottom a little more. And lower those heels down to the floor. And again, rising up, tracking the alignment. While the knees going over the second and the third toes and down to the center of the heel, even if it can't touch. One more time. And then pressing the heels down towards the ground. We're going to walk those hands forward into your plank. Scooping up that lower tummy, pressing out with the hands. Shoulders down, settle in. Breathe. And we rock forward and we rock back with the heels. And we push forward with the toes, and we rock back into the heels. Try not to let that bottom pop up when you rock back. Use those lower tummy muscles like you've zipped up a pair of really tight jeans from pubic bone to belly button, and it's holding you in there. Last time, I can also feel my arms burning. And lower those knees down. Point the toes, rock back to pose of a child. Take a breather. Taking a big breath. Bend those elbows. Move your wrists around a little bit. And roll it up. As when you are ready to. Lovely. Right, so let us go down onto your bums. Just doing this way. Feet sit bone distance apart today. And just using those arms to lift yourself up nice and tall. Nice straight back, head on top of your tail. And just for a moment rest there and let your bum feel really heavy on the ground. And then feel that your pelvis is stable on the floor, and from there build this really strong sense of energy coming up through the back of the spine, through the back of the neck, to the back of the head, lengthening the back of the skull. Big breath in. Keep your long line and just extend your arms, leaning back, or I should say tilting back on those sit bones. Breathing and breathing out. Do a little bicep curl, pulling yourself upright and back onto those sit bones. And lengthening back, lengthening like you were on a tilting table. Keep the ribs together, squeeze like you need a wee, and then coming back up. Nice strength in the biceps. We're going again. And lengthening it back. From here, start to tuck your tail under by breathing out from the lower tummy and let that curl the pelvis under. Scooping those ribs in, breathe into the back. Bending those elbows as you curl forward, head towards the middle of those knees. Find your sit bones and stack it back up nice and tall. Vertebra by vertebra, head on top of your tail. And again, exhale, lean back. Just lengthen those arms. Feel that long tilting table. Now start to tuck the tail under. Breathing out, it's not butt clenching. It's finding it there in the really deep belly. Tucking those lower ribs in, breathing into the back, bending the arms, rolling forward, coming up onto your sit bones, stacking it up tall. Leaning back, lengthening those arms, shoulders down. Start to tuck the tail under, breathing out from the lower belly. Let it push you round, tucking the ribs, bending those arms as you go forward. And peel it back up nice and tall. Extend your arms. We're going to just do a C scoop. Exhale, tuck that tail under, rocking it back. Hold it there, shoulders down. Pulse for eight. Pulsing eight and a seven and a six and five. Is it your hips bouncing you up and down, or are you using your tummy muscles? Stop there. Let's check. This time, pull it in eight times. In, 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 in. Now let's check if we were doing it right the first time. A little more from the tummy to bounce you up and down. Not the hip flexors. Three, two, and one. Tuck that chin in, curl forward, roll it back up again. Sit up nice and tall. This one we're going to feel. Breathe. Exhale, tuck that tail under. Find it again, that middle place. Try and keep the big toes down. Align the legs and pulse. Eight, and seven, and six, and five, and four, and three, and two. Come down about 10 centimeters. And pulse. Eight, and seven, and six, and five, and four, and three, and two. We're going to come up about 10 centimeters. Come back to where we were. Tuck those ribs in and pulse. Eight, and seven, and six. My pulse change. And four, and three, and two, and one. Roll all the way up. Hold it forward. Open up that chest. Nice and wide. Breathe in. Breathe out. So the ribs soften down, but the arms extend upwards. And then curl forward, pulling your tummy away from those thighs. We've done this pattern before. rolling it back, tuck the tail under. Breathe in, open those arms wide. Lift those arms up next to your ears. And exhale, curl it forward, tuck those lower ribs in. When you're on your sits bones, you sit up tall and open the arms wide. And lifting up, shoulders down, soften the ribs down, breathing out, curling forward. Scoop the tummy away from your thighs. Rocking back towards those heels, no neck tension. Open those arms out. Lift them up, soft shoulders, ribs down, and breathing out. Now we're going forward, and I'm going to find my sit bones. And we're going to open up those arms as we come to sit nice and tall. Give me a little twist. So to the right diagonal, ribs rotate. Not arm swing, ribs rotate and come back. And the knees don't move, because there's nothing, this has nothing to do with my legs. And coming back. And sometimes you can feel the hip flexors trying to help you. Can you try and isolate the abs a little more and the hip flexors say, thank you, no thank you. And then coming back into the center. So let's go back to what we were doing. Take a nice deep breath in. I wasn't finished with that. Breathe out, tuck that tail under, rolling it back down to the ground. Oh, not to the ground, sorry, halfway. And then we're, sorry, Bob. And then toes down, and we rotate to the right diagonal, and we come back in the middle. And the ribs rotating, the legs aren't moving, the hips aren't helping. A little twist, and back. And don't let the shoulders get over anxious. It's fine, we got this too. Twist, one repetition at a time. Sort out the technique, make it delicious, and roll it up. Tuck those ribs in, pulling the belly button in, scooping it back up, nice and tall. Inhale, I got two more. Exhale, tuck that tail under, rolling it back. Scooping in the belly, toes down halfway. Opening the right arm to the side, nothing else moves. And exhale, bring it in, let that rib kind of hug into the breastbone more. Inhale, left arm open to the side, shoulders relaxed. And exhale, squeezing it back in. And inhale, open the right one, shoulders down. I don't know when next I'll be able to talk to you in person, so I've got to make it count. Inhale, left one open to the side, and exhale, squeeze that rib in, and roll it forward. Toes down, find your sit bones, stack it up nice and tall, last one, I promise. Inhale, exhale, tuck that tail under, rolling it back. And we're going to bring those hands to the back of the head, shoulders down, and we're going to do the marching. Exhale, fold the right thigh up to your chest and bring it back down. And left one up to your chest. Oh, there is definitely a point of which I go one way or the other and I can feel the boundary. It's not because my thigh can't come any closer, it's because my stomach can't hold the balance anymore. And another two, and exhale, and inhale, I know you love me, and exhale, and lower it back down, thanks, roll down all the way to the ground, and just stretch it all out. Oh, that's so good. You see, it doesn't feel that good if you just do it without all the abs first. You're going to earn the feel-good factor. Right, let's just bring those legs back to a pelvic curl position. So feet in line with your sitting bones. And I'm going to bring those arms around like a big swimming motion down next to those hips. Let the shoulders press back, opening the chest a little bit. You're in neutral spine, it'll hollow under the lower back. And as you breathe out from the lower tummy, just roll the pelvis back, no bum clenching. Stand into those feet as you peel it up, vertebra by vertebra, knees reaching forward over the second and third toes. Get a lovely open line through the hips in front. And as you breathe out, soften the throat, the breastbone, soften the rib rings. Try not to overuse the gluteals and let them be such dominatrixes. Let them just chop. Inhale. And exhale from the lower tummy, let it push you back. Align your knees. They're in line with the middle of those hips and the second and third toes. Breathing in. And as you roll it down and you, everybody loves to focus on how nice it feels in the back.
But think about those inner and outer thighs extending and keeping that alignment of the legs and the weight balanced in your feet, in the tripods. Inhale, shoulders back. Exhale as you roll the pelvis back again, standing to those feet. Peeling it up. Shoulders back. We're going to go right knee up to tabletop. And lower it down, toe ball heel. Left knee up to tabletop. And lower it down, toe ball heel. Try to keep the pelvis really still. Right leg up. And lower it down. And left leg up. And lower it down, right leg, and down, and left, and down. Think about those upper arms, press them into the floor, hips up, standing into the tripods of your feet, and then melt your way down and think about the back widening as you peel down into the floor, vertebra by vertebra, trying not to clench, not to tense, not the hips, not the glutes. And land it back to neutral. We're going to take those arms up and back, reaching back behind. And exhale, bring those arms forward in a little chest lift. Sliding those hands down, not tucking the pelvis. Inhale, reach those arms back. Roll your back onto the floor, into imprint. Fold the knees up towards your chest. Inhale, putting them down, toe ball, heel. Try to hold onto your imprint until your back feels safely supported by the feet. And then we curl up, tucking those ribs in, gently pressing the back into the ground from the top to the bottom, not by tucking the hips. And then lowering it back down through the upper back. Now deal with the lower. Breathe out from the lower tummy. Let the back roll into the floor. There's a little curl before you fold the knees into your chest. And then lowering those feet down, hold on to the pelvic, curl there until you are safely on the floor with your feet. Then release the spine and then back into that chest lift, curling those arms up, shoulders are down, and then lowering it back overhead one more time, rolling the pelvis back into the floor to pick up the knees. Now I want you to just extend the left leg out along the ground and then take your hands, lace the fingers over the top of that right shin. So if you find this is too hard, you go underneath the right leg. That'll be easier. So we're going to curl it up, a supported roller, holding onto that right leg, shoulders down. For me, this always has value, no matter how easy or hard you find it, because it gives you an opportunity to find the counterbalance in your body, to manage your body weight. Inhale. That's good. Just to where you can get to. And then come back down again, just staying in the middle. Go to where you can, but stay in the middle. So I think part of why it's easier to go underneath with the hands is that automatically your hamstring fires into your hands. Here you've really got to think about using the back of your leg and not just the thigh. And if, yeah, and roll it back down again. And if you don't, your legs just going to kick out basically. So when we do a roll up, the back of the leg is active. It's got to be to stay down on the floor. And then rolling it back down again, tucking that tail under. Open those arms out into the air and just stretch that right leg up and bend it back down. A couple more times. Stretch it up and bend the leg back down. And stretch the leg up. And bend it back down. Now with a heel, flex the foot, push the heel up. And then bend it, bring it back to your bottom. And pushing it back up. And then bringing it back to your bottom. And another time, extend it up. And then bend it, point your toes. We're going to go into bicycling. So extend that right leg up into the air, lower it down straight. Bend the knee up to your chest. Extend it up, lower it down straight. Bend the knee to your chest. And extend. And lengthen down and a bend. Again, extend, lengthen down and bend. Reverse that. Stretch the leg out in front. Kick the leg up. Bend the knee in. So stretch it, kick it up. Bend it in. Stretch it out. Kick it up. Bend it in. One more. Out. Up and in. Lace those hands on top of that leg again. And just give a little hug towards you. And then we'll stretch it out, swapping legs. So we've got the left one, folding that knee in, lacing over either the top or underneath the legs, you decide. And then breathe that out as you tuck the chin in and you find the back of your leg pushing down. It's like I'm trying to do a toe tap with that left leg. And lift if you get to the top. And then exhale, tuck that tail under and roll it back down. And I encourage you to keep kinky elbows. I always sort of think, I think of Patrick Swayze in Dirty Dancing. And he says to Jennifer, this is my dance space. And that is your dance space. And that's exactly it. This is my space. And I don't want my knee or my shoulders crowding my chest space. And I just want to keep that, you know, that sense of grace. And respect for one another's space. And one more time, tucking that tail under and rolling it back down to the floor, not letting the shoulders overwhelm you. And just fold that knee in for a moment, just stretching the back of that hip. Extend the leg up into the air as we open the arms to the side. And we bend that left leg and we stretch it back up. And again, bend it. And think of it like elastic, because that's exactly what it should be like. It shouldn't feel like something that's gonna snap. Flex the foot, push the heel up, and feel the elastic up the back of the leg, bending. If something says you can't, that's most likely your brain saying, no, you can't do that. But the muscles are going, no, let me try. Point that leg going into the bicycling, extend that left leg up, lower it forward straight, bend the knee up to your chest, extend it up, reach it forward lower, bend it into your chest, and extend, lower down, bend it in, one more, extend, lower down, bend it in, reverse, kick it out straight, lift it up, bend the knee in, and extend it out, lift it up, and a bend, and a stretch, and a lift, and one more, and a stretch, and a lift, and bend it back in. Nice. Let's just take that leg in our hands again, get it a nice little cuddle. Bring both knees into your chest. Big surprise, what's next? So you can either use the top or underneath the legs, taking a deep breath in, kinky elbows to keep the shoulders relaxed, and rolling it up, tucking those ribs, tucking those ribs in, pulling it up, vertebra by vertebra. And breathe out, perfect. And roll it back down, take control. Beautiful. And again, and rolling it up. Lift. And exhale, tuck that tail under, curling it back down to the ground. One more for good luck. Rolling it, slow it down, be in charge. You want to feel where that power is coming from. I keep sneaking into my shoulders today. And then hold it here. Bring those hands behind the head. Scoop up into the chest lift. Look towards those knees. We're going to take the knees back to tabletop and alternating right leg to toe tap. Exhale, bring it back up. Left leg, inhale, lower tap. And exhale, lift it back. Good. We are tucking those lowest ribs in under the heart and lungs and flattening that tummy. Trying not to strain in the chest or the throat. And this is my last of this version. And now I want to go to just alternating a little faster. Switch them out. One and two and one and two. Elbows nice and wide. The hands are there to support the weight of the head, not to hold you up. And keep those top abdominal muscles firing to hold you. And two, and one. Bring both the knees in, lay the head back down, hands on the head. Stretch both legs up into the air, bend the knees. Stretching them up. Feel the inseams of your legs zipped closed. And again, and extend it up. And as the legs go up, you want to feel the weight of the backside on the floor increase. Back is on the ground, ribs are softening down. Flex your feet now, and as you push it up, put footprints on the ceiling. As you bend your knees, keep your feet parallel to the ceiling and press back up again. And I'm not going to have much of a bend because I'm trying to keep my legs together. Press and push those heels up. And again, and exhale and press. Hold it there, ribs down. Rotate the legs to turn out from the hips and rotate them back parallel. And rotate the legs to turn out. Squeeze the back of the legs together and back parallel. I'm breathing out and zipping up those extra tight jeans from pubic bone to belly button. One more time, turn them out, hold it there. We're gonna bend the knees outwards, bringing the heels to your crotch. Extend those legs out, push out with the heels and zip the back of the legs together. And bend those knees out, knees, heels to your crotch, push out through the heels and zip it back up. And again, and a bend, and extend, and zip it up, and a bend. Push them out with the heels, and zip it back up. One more time, bend heels to crotch, push out like a frog, and zip it back up, reverse. Open those legs, keeping the heels pushed out, bend heels to crotch, and then press the ceiling up with those heels. Zipping the back of the legs, open, and then bend, and zip and close. And stretch it open, and bend the heels to the crotch, and press it back up one more time, and open, and bend the heels to the crotch, and press it back up, turn the legs back to parallel, give me a nice big breath in, scoop up into your chest lift, and we start the proper bicycling, lower the right leg down, bend the left leg, extend the left leg up, bend the right leg. Extend the right leg up, bend the left leg. Extend the left leg up, bend the right. And a stretch, and a bend, and a stretch. Keep that chest lift nice and high. Cool. So you tuck those lower ribs in under the heart and lungs. And one more, and then go the other way. And we're cycling backwards, cycling backwards. Feel the push and the pull. Try and feel that splitteration going on. Tucking those lower ribs in, pull the tummy in. Make it count because it's so great to challenge your body because you have control over this. And bend those knees, bring them back in. Have a mo flow. So we can just circle those knees around using your arms. And then let's bring it back to putting those feet on the floor in line with your sits bones. We're going back to another pelvic curl. So from neutral spine, taking a deep inhale, shoulders back. Exhale as you roll the pelvis back, standing into your feet, peeling it up vertebra by vertebra. So press those upper arms back into the floor, getting the hips up. And now when you stand on that left leg, feel the weight transfer and keep the pelvis super still as you bend the right knee up and then stretch that right leg into the air. We're going for the whole kick series here. Flex the foot lower down, point and swing it up. Flex and lower down. Point and swing it up. Two more times, we'll do sets of four. One more, and then we're going into bicycling backwards. Bend the knee, press it out straight, swing the leg up. Bend the knee, stretch it out forward and swing up. Bend it in, stretch forward and swing up. Bend it in, stretch forward, swing up reverse. Lower that leg down, bend the knee up to your chest and extend to the ceiling. Pressing back with those upper arms, standing into the left foot. Keep breathing. Two to go. You got this. And one more time. Lower. Bend it in. Stretch it up. Bend that leg. Put it down. Feel the weight transfer from the right into the left. Press back with those arms. Hips up. Left knee up. Extend that leg into the air. And we go. Peel to flex. Lower down. Point and lift up. Flex. Lower down. Point and lift up. Flex and a lower. Point and a lift. One more time, stand on that right leg, go into the bicycling, forward, bend, and up, and reach forward, bend, and up, and reach forward, bend, and up. Keep the hips up, when the left leg goes down, the pelvis does not reverse, bend, stretch, and kick, and bend, stand on the backs of those arms, and bend, stretch, and kick, and one more, this is a marathon. And bend the knees, put that foot back down on the floor. Take those arms up and back, lift the hips a little bit more, breathe in. And roll down away from your fingertips. And say, thank you, body, that was pretty cool. You're amazing. Opening those arms out to the side. Walk your feet a little bit wider. So I'd like to feel that my feet are on the outer edges of my mat at least. And then tick-tocking those knees from right side to left side. And guys, you can do the breathing. I'll talk through the breathing just for those who want to do that version. When you rock your knees over to, let's say, the left, you breathe into the right back of the ribs. When you breathe out, let the back of those ribs slide down, relaxing the shoulders, and the tone in the tummy pulls the legs back. And then breathing into the back of the left as the knees go right, and as the ribs come down, the tone in the tummy from the exhale pulls you back. I'm just going to keep going with this. But the next time everybody finds themselves with their knees to the right, if you could just pause there for a moment, and we'll just go together for this next piece. So start this movement from the right leg. Let the right knee start to roll back, and just feel how it starts to change the pelvis, the atmosphere of the pelvis. It pushes the pelvis over, and the pelvis takes the left leg with it. And then everything flops over to the left. And then that left leg starts the movement. And as the left knee is coming up, feel the moment where it is changing things in your pelvis, rolling it back. And then the other leg gets involved and just comes through. So you're not anticipating what needs to happen. You are just feeling it. You're not doing what I'm telling you to do. You're feeling what your body can do biomechanically through this movement. And I've got a distinct feeling that certainly today the one side is a lot looser than the other. And I can just feel the movement is different from one side to the other. And if I don't take this time out in our classes to think about this kind of stuff, I never give my body this much attention. I never apply myself or make myself mentally available to my body like I do when I'm here. When you come back into the center the next time, we're just going to stop there. We'll press feet in a little bit closer. We're going to stretch out, reaching back overhead. We're going to cross the right leg over the left leg at the ankle. And then just have a little push out. So just leaning with the body to the left, kind of moving it to the left like a banana away from that right hip. And then I'd like you to flex the right foot, which is the foot on top. And I just push out through that heel and feel that. It's subtle, it's a little fascial stretch, and then backing off, bring the body back into the center, and wrap the right foot, wrap over the left foot, and then just shifting the body into the banana towards the right side. And as you breathe out, flex that left foot and just push out through the left hand, up overhead. It's nice because the floor is there to prevent you from doing any flexion. Backing off, coming back into the center. We're going to do a regular roll-up or any roll-up you like to do. Just curling up through the spine. Lovely. So here I'd like us to cross again the right leg over the left leg. And we're just going to do a spinal extension here. So breathing in. Sitting nice and tall. Breathe out. I just want you to flop over those legs. Relaxing your thighs, relaxing your knees. Taking a big breath in. Breathe out as you lift the arms. And the arms are lifting your chest. And we are coming back up nice and tall. Shoulders down. Inhale. Exhale. And we are going to fold forward. Imagine there was a big pillow on your lap and you were just flopping over that big pillow. Allowing the head to rest, letting the arms come down to rest, breathing into the back.
And then start to extend those arms forward, extend through the fingertips, and let the arms lift your chest, ears between the biceps, and just coming back up, nice and tall, shoulders down. We'll do it one more time with this leg on top, and lengthening, and flopping over, pulling up the belly, rounding that back. So we're not just, even if you could just lie on your legs, you're not quite like that. This tummy engagement. And then reaching those arms forward, extending past those ankles, letting the arms lift you back up, nice and tall. And then just bring those arms down. We're going to put them behind your heels on the ground into our inverted plank. So we push down on the back of those legs and lift the chest up. Lift the girls to the ceiling, open the shoulders, breathe. And then long spine as your buttocks reaches back for the floor. It's coming back to sit itself down. Inhale. And exhale, push down against the feet. Open the chest, push the girls up to the ceiling. Breathing and then lengthening the spine, lowering your butt back down onto the floor. Good. One more time. Inhale. And exhale, lifting that chest up. So think of the pubic bone leading the way. Don't let that lower tummy poof out. And then lowering the bum back down to the ground to come to that spinal extension of the other leg on top. Just taking a nice deep breath in and breathe out as you peel yourself forward, relaxing your thighs, relaxing your hips, even your kneecaps. Inhale into the back. Exhale, extending those arms forward. Let the arms lift the chest. Feeling the relationship, feeling where the arms are attached to your back through those lats. Inhale and exhale and reaching forward, relaxing your hips, relaxing your thighs. Going into a lovely butt stretch there, I hope, because of the crossed over feet. Let the arms come all the way down, breathe into the back, right down into your bottom, and then let the arms extend forward, relaxing the neck and shoulders. Head reaching towards the fingertips and lifting back up. Inhale. And again, exhale, lengthening that spine, folding over the front, letting the arms and shoulders relax. Deep inhale into the bottom. And then arms reaching forward and up and just coming back into that lovely tall position. Super, coming back down with those hands. So we're going to bend those legs back up to tabletop, hands on the floor, and go for a little roll. So we're going to stretch those legs up. It's a pattern we used on Wednesday. From there, we're going to let that roll us back, extending the legs back, hands on the ground, peel to flex, separate your feet, and then roll it back down through your spine, keeping your head and the back of your arms on the floor, opening the chest as your butt unravels to the ground. Point, circle, close, bend your knees, hands under the thighs to rock or roll up. Tuck those chins in. That sounds like I'm implying you have many. And then stretching those legs, hands on the ground, long spine. There's the V-sit. There's my nice control rollover. Flex those feet, separate those legs. As you roll back down, imagine there was elastic cords on your heels, pulling your legs the other way, putting your heels the other way as you pull in the tummy and let the tummy push you to the ground. Point, circle, close. Hands underneath as you bend and rock or roll back up into that sitting position. And one more time. Inhale, stretch. Lengthen that spine, hands down. Exhale, roll it over, stretching those legs back. Peel to flex. Separate, push out the heels back behind you and roll it back down. Unraveling your back into the floor. Keep flexing those feet. That's it. Circle, bring them back together. And then bend those knees. Hands underneath those thighs. Stay right there, breathing in. Breathe out as you scoop up into that chest lift, tucking the ribs in. Going for a double leg extension. We're going to inhale, stretch it out. Exhale, circle it round, reach towards the ankles. Lower back on the floor. Inhale, stretch it out. And exhale, circle round. Good. And again, and inhale, reach it out. And exhale, circle it round. So we are going to try and turn this. As you reach out, let's turn to our side.
And then as you breathe out, we're going to come back.
Back into the floor. Tap. Inhale, extend it out to the other side. Try and get fully committed. And then coming back all the way around. And again, and inhale and extend it out. Find that nice reach, fingertips to toes, ooh, fully committed without flopping. And then coming back, I feel like a fish out of water. And one more time, reaching it out. Ooh, fully committed. And then sparkling it back in. Oh, I love that, that's hard. Stretch both legs up into the air and we do switches. Inhale, exhale, exhale, swap, exhale, exhale, swap, exhale, exhale. Shoulders are down. Feel how you are anchored and supported by the ground under your back. And last two. Bring them back in and lay it back down. I think we definitely warmed up our abs today. That always is a delight. Shall we go ahead and take it up to go onto your tummies? Right. Okey-dokey. Pointing those toes. Hands underneath your shoulders. Nice and long spine here. Taking a deep breath into the back. Breathe out and just gently press the pubic bone towards the mat, lifting the lower tummy. And you may sense the lower back lengthening out a little bit. If you just clenched with your glutes, stop it. And then back it back off. Because we're trying to isolate those tummy muscles. Again, breathe out, find the lower tummy as it pulls up off the floor, pubic bone into the ground without the butt clench. Don't get me wrong, your glutes will be active, they just won't be pouting. One more time, letting it go. And exhale, and that little tuck of the pelvis, keep that lower belly in. I think sometimes we forget that's where we need to be. And now with as little effort as possible, reach both legs back, keeping that position, tummy lifted, and float the legs just off the floor. Hold it there. And now without using the power of your hands, let's float the chest just off the floor. So you're resting on that lower rib, your pubic bone and your two hip bones. Your hands are there. I'm going to do a tiny little rock like a rocking horse, pushing into the hands, pushing into the legs, pushing into the hands, pushing into the legs. Think of the back of your legs from sit bone to heel. As you push them up, it presses your chest down a little bit. But I'm not allowing my back to arch any further. I'm not making it any bigger. I just want to feel the back of the body really. And one more time. And then lower it back down to the ground. Full swan. Breathe out, press that pubic bone into the floor, scooping up the lower tummy, ribs softening down. Try not to let those shoulders bunch up next to your ears. Inhale and exhale and lengthen to lower it down. Shoulders down, elbows back. Yes, that's better. Good. Inhale and exhale. Elbows go back down. Lengthen through the crown of your head. Ribs are softening down as you breathe and lowering it back down. How high you go is entirely up to you and how your body feels. Never go into pain. Never, never, ever go into pain. Find length, find stretch, and that can feel quite delicious or masochistic, depending how you look at it. And we're going to go one more time. Just bringing it up. Good. And now I want you to scoop that belly in, round that back, and rock back to your heels. So we're going to go into an exercise we haven't done in a long time. From the up stretch, we're going to go into an arabesque with the leg at the back and then rock forward into our front leg pull. So we've done all the bicycling today to kind of warm us up for this kind of stuff. So hopefully it'll go beautifully, swimmingly, shall we say. So let's tuck under those toes onto all fours.
We're going to push the hips up into the air. Now, this may be my hands further forward than I'm used to on my up stretch, because I know I'm going to be rocking into plank, and I'm just going to test that distance, actually. Make sure it's comfortable on the wrists, and then push back into that up stretch. Stick out the bottom. We're going to pick up the left leg. Stand on the right one, bend the left foot, and now lift that thigh bone up. Point your knee up to the ceiling, and then stretch from knee to toe, pushing it up, 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 up. You're allowed to let that hip open on this. We're going to rock forward, bring the knee to the chest in the plank. And then toe up to the ceiling and stretch. And again, bend knee in. And toe up to the ceiling and stretch. Good. Again, and toe in. And now lead with that toe. Get that foot pointed up to the ceiling. Stretch it up. We're bending it forward. And we'll step back onto that left foot. Breathe in. Breathe out into your up stretch. How are your wrists? Do you need a rest? Okay, bend that right leg, put the foot off the floor, take that thigh bone back, point the knee to the ceiling, and then extend from knee to toe, pressing the chest to your thighs. And here we go, fold forward, knee to chest, toe up to the ceiling and stretch, and knee to chest, and toe up to the ceiling and stretch. And again, breathe in, and exhale out. Bring it into your chest. Step back onto that foot. Lower the knees down. Push the bum back. Ah, relax those arms. Again, stretch the wrists if you like. Just give them a little shaky, shaky. You guys are so strong. You're going to kick this thing's butt. It's all good. It's all good. Taking a nice big breath. Rolling it up. We're going to just come to a kneeling, tall kneeling position. I'm falling out of my hair. It's been a workout today. Taking the left arm up, breathing. Breathe out, let's do a little side bend, just stretching right through to those fingertips. And then coming back up again. Now I want you to step forward with your right foot. Now I've got your right arm up, haven't I? Yeah. Left arm up. I took my right foot. Right foot steps forward. Just into a little lunge. So there's a plumb line, a box space there. And I just want you to bring your pubic bone slightly forward. Just tuck that pelvis ever so slightly, scooping in the lower tummy, and you should already feel that hip is stretching a little bit more. Breathing, extend through the fingertips, through the elbow, through the wrist, and then just nice little side bend. Keep growing tall and long. Head up. Try not to drop it forward. Breathing down that side. And bringing it back up. We're going to shift the right foot slightly forward, and I'll lunge to let the crotch come forward and down towards that heel, and give it a moment, give it a breath, and maybe you can give more permission as you relax into it. And then again, keeping that head up, just that lovely side bend. So you could, if you can reach, put that right hand fingertips on the floor to balance and circle that left arm around. Bending that one, just taking a nice lift through that right arm, shoulder down, pubic bone forward, always in my head, got to think pelvis and neutral, zip up the front of the pelvic floor, and then just extending over to the side, starting to stretch open that tissue, and again, I reach through the shoulder joint, through the elbow, through the wrist, through the fingers, but without tension, and make it long and spacious and breathy, and then coming back. We're going to take the left foot forward on the lunge. Tuck that pubic bone to the front slightly, giving us that little hip stretch. And breathing. Oh, and if you can, a little reach to the side. I'm easily confused. Head back, breathing. And then coming back. Take that foot a little bit further forward, crotch forward and down towards the heel in front. Give it permission, actively make that decision and go, oh, it's okay, I can go a little bit more. And then if you want to use those fingertips to the ground, finding that side bend. Just opening the side of the body, still the head is back. Neck extensors still doing their function. And circle round for three. And for two. Lovely. And four. And then backing off. Coming back onto our knees, hands and knees. Tuck under the toes. Push those hips up into the air. Shake out the neck. Walk those hands back to the feet, getting the heels down onto the ground. Soften the knees, taking a big breath into the back. And rolling it up vertebra by vertebra, just picking up your energy as you go. Just breathing. There's been the most incredible energy in the room today, actually. It's been just really hard work and